I believe that no one needs to be a Jew or a Christian to be go to China.
But according to you, yeah. But according to you, whoever doesn't believe that Jesus,
I don't believe that.
So you don't believe in that. So you don't believe in the salvation.
No. If no, as you say,
go on.
Go to China, you don't need to be a Jew. We believe as a Christian, Jew are killers. They kill the server.
Okay.
When you receive that one, yeah, Jews are not.
But they're saying the Jews are saying that you can only by being Jew you can go to paradise.
No.
Do you disagree with that? No. Fantastic, brilliant. No. What about being a Christian?
Because
good. I agree.
The server.
I agree.
They don't have access.
Yep.
To condemn people as a Muslim or Christian.
Fantastic.
First, they go to the land. And if no one is a judge.
Yes.
God himself is the judge.
Yes. I agree with you. So you agree. What about if I, yeah. What about if I don't believe that Jesus died for my sins? Would I go to paradise? Could you?
The same thing as just I'm the judge.
Fair enough.
I can't judge you. But the word of God says that.
What if I know? What if hypothetically, let's say if I do know that Jesus was speaking the truth, according to you, that Jesus died for their sins, and I reject Jesus died for my sins, would I still go to paradise?
Truth or the word of in the Bible, it says,
yes.
One who rejects Jesus Christ as a son of God is Antichrist.
So what do you mean by son of God?
The son of God is God having his beloved son.
What do you mean by son? What do you mean by son of God? That's what I want you to clarify.
Thank you. The son of God is God before the world created.
Okay.
He preserved Christ to save the world.
He preserved the world Christ to save the world.
Yeah. Before the world created,
right.
It was like a lamp of God.
Okay.
A lamp of God is beside him.
Right.
This lamp of God, once he sent to Ishmael, for example, to Abraham time, and Abraham sacrificed that one, he redeemed for him. When the Israelites go from Egypt, the same thing, the lamp of God, they put the blood on the post of their house when they go. And the firstborn of Egypt, they kill it by angel, and the rest doesn't.
Okay.
This is analogy to form.
Okay.
The lamp of God, the blood in Egypt, and Jesus Christ as well. He's not the son of God.
Okay, so again, your belief is not based on what Jesus told you. See, everything that you said, that's from the church fathers. They took this. They took this. The Lamb of God. Do you remember our first principle in our discussion? That our belief is one side. It's about the evidence, right? And you're a Christian, right? So you have to follow the teachings of Jesus. Do you follow the teachings of the church or the teachings of Jesus?
Jesus,
brilliant. So what you're telling me, that's the teachings of the church. But I want you to tell me, where did Jesus say he's the Lamb of God? Where did Jesus say he died?
Well, I'm talking now about Abraham before the church created.
No, I'm talking about Jesus. Remember, who is the Messiah? The church or Jesus?
Jesus.
Fantastic. So what did Jesus say? Did Jesus ever describe himself as the Lamb of God? No, he's not. So what I'm trying to say to you is,
when Jesus comes to baptize, there was a man before him.
Okay, John the Baptist. Yes, John the Baptist, yeah.
John the Baptist, he witnessed about Jesus. Behold, the Lamb of God comes, he kept away the sins of the world.
Yeah, but that's John the Baptist. What about Jesus?
You see? Jesus, he didn't for himself. He was one John the Baptist. The second is the voice of God, he said, this is my beloved son, I born today.
Yeah, but I'm talking about Jesus. Yeah. Well, you're trying to affirm Jesus by someone else's statement. No, if for example, the Jews, what do they accuse Jesus of? They accuse him to be possessed by devil. Would you take their statement?
They say that.
Would you take their statement?
No.
Exactly. So, did Jesus ever call himself
the
Lamb of
God? Prophet of God.
So we Muslims believe Jesus.
I got this one because not from the Jew, but especially John, I believe that the prophet of John.
Okay, brilliant.
I accept his witness.
Okay, you accept his witness.
Yeah, because he's a prophet.
Right. Why was Jesus back? baptized.
You're a zombie!
No, okay. Jesus baptized to repent for his sin.
So you're telling, wait, hang on. So Jesus got baptized to repent for his sins, but yet Jesus had to die.
Jesus
was baptized.
Yeah.
What's the reason of baptism?
Oh, wait. When Jesus comes, he comes from the other type of the Jews. At that time, they have the animal sacrifice and baptized in water.
Okay, no, I'm talking about. I'm not talking about the baptism water. Yeah. I'm saying, what's the purpose of baptism?
Baptism for washing up sin.
Brilliant. So, was Jesus baptized?
Okay. Jesus comes to fulfill the prophets. Before the prophets, they say the Messiah will come, and he cut off himself, not for himself, but for the sin of others.
But hang on,
I
want you to think logically, right? So Jesus needs to be baptized to wash for his own sins, but yet he can die for our sins. Does that even make sense to you?
No, for his own sin.
So do you believe Jesus was born as a sinner?
Jesus Christ is purely holy.
But if it's pure,
we must have the sin of the man.
But if it's purely holy, then why does he need to be baptized?
Why I say holy? Because sin comes from the sin of man.
Right, again,
because of Adam and sin.
Again, you're forgetting the point. You're now appealing to the hypostasis. That Jesus has a divine nature and a human nature. That's what you're appealing. So I want you to tell me anywhere from the Bible where Jesus says that he's fully divine and fully human at the same time.
According to sin, the definition of sin, sin comes from who? From Adam.
With all due respect, do you remember our first principle?
Yeah.
We brought our belief to one side.
Yeah.
It's all about the evidence.
Yeah.
The evidence is what builds our belief, correct? It's not the other way around.
Yeah.
We don't formulate our belief first and then we look for evidence. Yeah? We build our belief based upon evidence. Based on evidence.
Now, why are you asking me that? Yeah. Why Jesus Christ is baptized? That's your question.
Yeah, according to the Bible.
Thank you.
Not according to your belief or my belief.
In the Old Testament, the Jews, Christians and Muslims, we have holy prophets.
Yes.
Yeah. This holy prophet before 2000 is Isaiah, for example.
Okay.
He wrote that a message will come. When he comes, he cut off people, they cut him. Not for his sin, but for the sin of others. This is the holy prophet wrote that one.
Did Jesus ever claim he died for his sin?
Now we come to evidence. It is a witness. That is John.
I told you again.
Yeah.
Look, even the Jews, for example, did they accuse Jesus of many stuff, right?
Yeah, many stuff.
Would you take their statement as a truthful statement?
Why
didn't Jesus himself, if Christianity, if salvation is so important in your belief, why didn't Jesus say that? Thank you very much. Why didn't Jesus himself say that I come here to die for your sins? Why not? If it's so important. For example, look.
Do you remember when the high priest here asked him, are you the son of the blessed one?
Yeah.
He asked him.
Yeah.
You said so.
Okay. So you're quoting from Mark chapter 14, verse 53-65, right? So when he was put on the trial, right?
Yeah.
Pontius Pilate.
Yeah.
Yeah? That are you the son of God? And Jesus says, I am.
They didn't say, are you the son of God?
Son of the blessed one.
Yeah.
Who's the blessed
one?
Who's the blessed one?
No, there is no one.
Yeah, brilliant. So I'm correct, right? So Jesus says, I am. Again, the Son of God does not mean he's divine. Because if you read the Old Testament, there are signs by the tongues. In fact, if you read in Luke chapter 3, verse 38, there's a genealogy of Jesus. And the genealogy of Jesus, if you go to Adam, Adam is called the Son of God.
Even Adam?
Yes.
The son of God.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah, living soul.
So is Jesus.
Living soul.
So is Jesus.
Huh?
So is Jesus.
Okay.
See, you know this.
Okay, now. When Jesus comes, he comes, he's the word of God. Before he...
You're jumping on. We talk about the Son of God, not the word of God. We can come here, don't worry.
Yeah.
The Son of God, if you look at the genealogy of Jesus, in Luke chapter I think it's Luke chapter 3 verse 38, right? The genealogy, yeah. Right? It shows you that Jesus, the son of Joseph. If you look at Adam, son of God, in a genealogy. Genealogy, what does genealogy mean? What's the genealogy? Our ancestry.
The ancestors, just your family terms.
Yeah. So why was Adam included in the genealogy as a son of God? So therefore, the term son of God is not unique. Why? Jesus, peace be upon him, he says in the Gospel of John, chapter number 20, verse 17, when he says to Mary Magdalene, that go to your brothers and say, I have not yet ascended unto my Father, and I'm going to my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says very clearly that my relationship with the Father is not exclusive. My Father is your Father. My God is your God. So there's no special status when it comes to Son of God. Son of God means righteous people.